Welcome back to Lanced Swamps, where the swamps are lancy and the lances are swampy. I'm gonna go ahead and let these guys do some stuff, and I'll be back. Alright, I used Ghostetler, the guy that was really rich, up here as like a weather vane to see when I needed to start building better housing, and he has all this money, and he still got kicked out of that apartment, that crappy old human one. So I finished off these things here. I haven't assigned all the beds, but I also created another slum up here, which won't even have doors. It's just gonna have beds. And I'm having Arendorable carrying Imchim is horrible at making beds, but he's doing it anyway, and so hopefully we'll get some very cheap, crappy rooms for people to transition to when they run out of money. Somebody ended a mandate. Oh yeah, we've got a mandate to create zinc items, but I don't have zinc or the fixins for it, so problem. Also, these things here are preventing me from getting the lava trap activated, and no one will do anything with them. They won't act, they won't dump them, they won't do anything with them. So I don't know what to do. But, oh well, minor problem. Yeah, so every single building here, except for this one, which I've removed all but one pillar, and I haven't decided who's going to be the unlucky bastard to remove that one. But every building here has been reclaimed, and most of them are double ramped, or in the process of being double ramped, and then I will wall up the outside ramps once the stairway has been widened, or the walkway has been widened by two. So this is all now walled in, walled off, dwarf country, and some people have beds in some really weird places, you know, like, not here, I don't think anybody's got this one, but down here we've got Crazy, and Kissa, and Negative, and Nobody, and then I think there's someone down here. No, they haven't taken this one yet. But some of them are loners, and they want to be far, far away from the rest. So, moving on. The elves are here! Yay! Oh yeah, that's right. I forgot. Foggin wanted to be named after, or wanted the babby to be named after him. So there you go, Foggin, you are a babby now. Well, they've cleaned up the water the water that they spilled, and we are at about 6 out of 7 there, but the magma is still very slowly filling up here. Some of it's starting to get full. Yeah, there we go. 7 out of 7. And so, awesome. Our heated tub is nearly done. And hopefully they won't spill any more water. You there, gamer dude. Don't you dare spill that water. It's important. Whoever Wise Saigon is, he just arrived. He's a philosopher. Oh boy, more frickin' nobles. Stupid frickin' nobles and migrants. What does he want? Nothing. I like this noble. I forgot. Philosopher. Best noble ever. Best noble ever, you can stay. We'll make some bronze then, douchebag. Jeez, guys, what is so complicated about all of this? Look, smelt that, and then we do the bronzy thing, and then, you know, it's okay. You can do it. You can do it, guys! Disciples still not healed. He is still very, very hurt. And we're doing well on these. These are all $5, except the only person that needs one so far has been Trenton Fox. So, I guess he's the slum guy. He's the dwarven reject. And our magma thing here is almost full, and this water is evaporating very, very, very quickly. Oh yes, and we have a well here. Hooray, well, it is all well and good. And so everything's been very peaceful. We've had a couple kobolds, and Crazy's hanging out with that dog, and somehow this dog up here is still alive, even though it's covered in vomit. There's just vomit everywhere. Vomit. Yeah, poor little dog. Alright, well, we'll see what comes of this migration, and then I'll be back. So, this is interesting. Apparently, the dwarves are using the well, and they're getting water from it, and then they're taking the water down here, and they're filling this pond with the water from the well, which comes from this pond. So they go here, they get the water from here, and then they come from here, and then they go down here, and then they put it back here. I'm speechless. That's a new level of dwarfinism. Uh-oh, someone's going to jail. Okay, so the count is up to 141, and I've noticed something quite interesting. So the dwarves come up here, they go to this well, right? The well is connected to this pond down here. They take the water from this well, they go down this stair, they go down this stair, they go all the way over here, they go down, and then they come back in here, and then they took the water that they took out of the well, which is from here, and they put it back here. What? That's a whole new level of dwarven stupidity. So, alright, we got some more beds here. Unfortunately, oh wait, we got a family of two living in that one. Some of them are untaken yet, so not all hope is lost. Some people still have their rooms, but Trenton Fox is not alone in the slums anymore. Oh, snap! Well, drug unit is hauling Tim Ashcroft off to prison for 110 days for not following MYSET's carefully worded orders to create some crap out of, zinc. Yes, zinc. Unfortunately for Tim Ashcroft, we haven't got any zinc. So, I think we have enough jail, so yeah, we're good. We're working on getting the bronze bars required to make the other mandate happen, but that's coming slow. Disciple here is still freaking wounded, and we've done a lot on these walkways. The walkways are all double wide now. Far Out is still doing stuff, and this area here is about to be linked, and that guy's going to be trapped for a little bit once he makes this thing here. We are building a special thing up here, nothing dangerous, just more like just a fun thing. And most of the migrants have settled in and got rooms for themselves, and our secondary slum over here is going a little bit better, but not a lot of people are taking it, and I'm happy about that. I don't want my dwarves living in slums. We have a lot of people in this slum, though, that I'm still trying to get out of poverty. But, you know, I can only do so much. I'm a philanthropist. I'm a dwarf philanthropist, but there's only so much I can do. And we badly need to expand our furniture stockpile, so we're doing that. And I'm consolidating all of our pets and stuff, and so they've all been assigned to this one cage here, except for the ones like the stray elephant, the tame elephants. I don't want them in that cage. But all of them are going to be in this cage, and we will move from there. So, yeah, everything's going good. Oh yeah, Tim Ashcroft's got the right idea. Drug unit is about to take Tim Ashcroft to jail, but if you look in his inventory, he's taking a barrel of dwarven wine with him. He's like, damn it, you can take me to jail, but I'm taking my wine with me. Well, I hope he can survive off of that, and it doesn't explode in the heat, but he'll be alright. Oh man, we didn't get enough bronze from the melting to fill them. Oh wait, we did. No, never mind, we didn't. Alex wants more bronze. But we'll have enough iron to make bucklers, so we can do one of our mandates anyway. Someone threw a bucket. Oh no, that's from the well, okay. Yeah, somebody's using the well. What are you doing? Filling pond or giving? Okay, good. I think I solved the fill pond problem. Also, this area is now walled off and will soon be connected to the outside world. This guy is going to be very sad, because he doesn't have any way to get out of there just yet. But soon it will be connected to this, the rest of the Skybridge stuff, and then we will have a completely safe, large water source in here, and that will not be interruptible by goblins and whatever whatnot. So even if we do get attacked by goblins, we'll have a very large, safe water source. Added some more traps in choke points around the fortress, just pretty much all over. Wherever I could find a little choke point, I put some more traps, and our brave, slightly dead Ognob is still there, being brave, being slightly dead. I have no idea how, but somehow an elephant calf that's not tamed got out and is now in our magma forge area. Well, Nixeter is bravely trying to deal with it, but he's also bravely running away from it. So next time on Let's Play Dwarf Fortress, we will figure out what to do with this elephant calf running amok in our fortress. I'll probably send some soldiers down to deal with it, but for now, I'll just let him play with the iron and stuff. And our thing here is connected, and... Ah, here we go. I need to build one tile here. I'm making a gazebo. And then here, I'm going to put a bed right here. I can't do it now because it's not inside until I build the thing. And in this bed will be the philosopher with his room over the temple. Alright, so join me next time on Let's Play Dwarf Fortress to build walls and get ready for more arena fights and the eventual goblin plague where we will throw them off of the Gravitron. Yay!